ए वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द रिमेनिंग पार्ट ऑफ ईसीजी। इन बेसिक्स ऑफ ईसीजी पार्ट वन आई हैव डिस्कस अबाउट द कंडक्शन मैकेनिज्म ऑफ हार्ट, टाइप ऑफ लीड्स, ईसीजी पेपर, ईसीजी मशीन, हाउ टू इवेल्युएट द हार्ट रेट ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ स्मॉल स्क्वेयर, लार्ज स्क्वेयर, जंक्शनल बीट, साइनस बीट। आई हैव ऑल्सो डिस्कस अबाउट द रिदम ऑफ हार्ट। Determine now, focusing on the determining axis of ECG. Axis of ECG is the major direction of the overall electrical activity of heart. As we all know, SA node, AV node produces the electrical activity and is propagated and moves in all direction, right direction, left direction, upward and downwards. Normal axis of heart is fixed, it is 110 to minus 30. Rotation of heart around vertical axis in heart will be taken as the axis rotation. If the particular axis heart rotates toward left side, then it is left axis deviation. In case of left ventricle hypertrophy, if it is rotated toward right side, then it is the right axis deviation. To know the exact degree of deviation, we must focus on the lead L1 and AVF. Left axis deviation as it occurs in case of the left ventricle hypertrophy. So before that, we have to remember this. This is Anthoven triangle. As we can see, this is the lead L1, L2, L3. All these three leads are bipolar leads because two electrodes are tied for each lead. For the L1 lead, one electrode will be tied over the left arms and the right arm, L2 right arms and left foot. For three left arms and the left foot, each lead will tell us the difference between the electrical potential of both sides or the and difference between the electrical potential between these two electrodes. So this is the same thing. This is Anthoven triangle. It will be drawn as like this. Here minus 30 AVL augmented voltage of left arm, augmented voltage of right arm, augmented voltage of foot. Why it is known as the augmented? Because as we know, it is tied over the wrist and connected to the centrally neutral electrical central terminal electrical neutral, and it is the augmented. So we have to look after L1 and AVF. So this diagram is coming from the this. If this is the AVF, is the augmented voltage of foot, augmented voltage right arm, left arm. So in the same direction. This is the central neutral. So it is connected to that place, that's why it is known as the augmented. Now, on the basis of this ECG tracing, we have to evaluate whether it's left axis, right axis. As I told you, to evaluate the axis, we have to see the L1 and AVF. And you have to remember, if the electrical impulse moves toward that particular electrode, it will form the positive deflection. If the electrical current moves away from the electrode, it will form the negative deflection. In the AVF, it's the negative deflection, and in the L1 lead, positive deflection upside. So in the V1 it is positive and AVF is negative. So if AVF is positive, then it will be like this in this place. If in this strip it's showing the negative, so what we have to do? We have to see the AVF to the just opposite direction. 90, it will be known as the minus AVF. If it's negative, we have to see to the opposite direction. As the L1 is this, it is positive, and AVF is the negative deviation. If it's positive, then we have to stick to this point, but if it's negative, then we have to look to the opposite direction, in this direction. तो L1 AVF इज कवरिंग दिस एरिया दिस पार्ट एंड दिस पार्ट इज द लेफ्ट साइड सो इट्स टेल अस अबाउट द लेफ्ट वेंट्रिकल हाइपरट्रॉफी ओके इफ इट्स दैट्स पार्ट लाइक इन दिस वी कैन सी दिस लेफ्ट एक्सिस डेविएशन दिस इज इंडिकेटिंग द एरिया कवर बाई दिस डायरेक्शन नोन एज द लेफ्ट एक्सिस डेविएशन इन द सेम वे द राइट एक्सिस डेविएशन विल बी कैलकुलेटेड एंड नाउ वी सी द एबनॉर्मलिटी विच फाउंड इन द केस ऑफ द LAD लेफ्ट एक्सिस डेविएशन लेफ्ट वेंट्रिकल हाइपरट्रॉफी लेफ्ट बंडल ब्रांच राइट एक्सिस डेविएशन राइट वेंट्रिकल हाइपरट्रॉफी राइट बंडल ब्रांच पोजिशन ऑफ हार्ट नॉर्मल पोजिशन ओपेक अब नॉर्मल पोजिशन लाइक द पोजिशन शिफ्टेड डाउनवर्ड लेफ्ट साइड इन केस ऑफ हॉरिजेंटल हार्ट इन केस ऑफ लेफ्ट वेंट्रिकल हाइपरट्रॉफी पोजिशन शिफ्टेड टुवर्ड्स द राइट साइड वर्टिकल हार्ट इट विल बी सीन इन द राइट वेंट्रिकल हाइपरट्रॉफी रोटेशन राइट वेंट्रिकल हाइपरट्रॉफी इट विल बी क्लॉकवाइज रोटेशन लेफ्ट वेंट्रिकल एंटी क्लॉकवाइज रोटेशन S wave on the basis of S wave prominent clockwise rotation indicate about the right ventricle hypertrophy. S wave if absent tell us about anticlockwise rotation left ventricle hypertrophy. S wave just absent means normal. Now the intervals PR interval QRS interval distance between onset of P wave and the onset of Q wave known as the PR interval but it should be labeled as the PQ interval. But it is known as the PR interval. Normal time taken 0.12 second to 0.20 second. Normally it covered the 3 to 5 small square. QRS interval distance between onset of Q wave and end of S wave. It will cover normally it covers the 2 to 3 small square and it will take the time 0.08 to 0.12 second. Segment as we all know it's isoelectric so between two segment there will be no electric impulse there will be no wave end of P wave and start of Q wave it is always isoelectric ST segment end of S wave and onset of T wave and TP segment end of T wave onset of next P wave importance used to compare ST segment whether it's normal elevated in case of ischemia depressed in case of ischemia and MI interferences abnormality in the ECG it can be abnormality it can be like rhythm arrhythmia conduction block it can be due to the chamber hypertrophy in case of right atrium left atrium hypertrophy left ventricle hypertrophy right ventricle hypertrophy or either it can be bundle branch block right bundle branch block left bundle branch block ischemic heart disease it is of two type angina pectoris and MI myocardial infarction electrolyte imbalance also causes the abnormality in the ECG like the hyperkalemia and hypokalemia arrhythmia there are the terminology like the sinus tachycardia when the heart beats between 100 to 160 beats per minute sinus bradycardia when heart rate is less than 60 per minute sinus arrhythmia during inspiration blood collected in heart it increases the heart rate ECG complex will increase RR interval will decrease during expiration blood become less in heart heart rate will slightly decrease RR interval will slightly increase there are other terminology like the atrial tachycardia heartbeat will be between 160 to 250 220 per minutes atrial flutter it will be heart rate will be between 250 to 350 beats per minute in this P wave complex is not transmitted to ventricle so QRS is formed after 4 consecutive P wave so ratio will be 4:1 atrial fibrillation more than 350 ventricle tachycardia there will be no P wave deformed QRS complex is equal large shape after equal interval ventricle fibrillation P wave is not visible QRS complex unequal deformed coming at unequal interval जस्ट बिफोर डेथ ड्यू टू एनी कॉज हार्ट गोज इन टू वेंट्रिकल फिब्रिलाइजेशन. दिस इज द नाउ आई एम गोइंग टू टेल अबाउट द कंडक्शन ब्लॉक हार्ट ब्लॉक टाइप्स ऑफ वी कैन ऑल्सो से द आर्टरी वेंट्रिकुलर ब्लॉक फर्स्ट डिग्री हार्ट ब्लॉक सेकेंड डिग्री हार्ट ब्लॉक एंड थर्ड डिग्री हार्ट ब्लॉक. इट कैन ऑल्सो बी नोन एज द फर्स्ट डिग्री ए वी हार्ट ब्लॉक सेकेंड डिग्री आर्टरी वेंट्रिकुलर हार्ट ब्लॉक थर्ड डिग्री आर्टरी वेंट्रिकुलर हार्ट ब्लॉक एंड फर्स्ट डिग्री हार्ट ब्लॉक. हाउ कैन वी कैलकुलेट? वी कैन से इफ पी आर इंटरवल इज मोर देन 0 to 2 seconds मोर देन 5 mm इट विल बी नोन एज द फर्स्ट डिग्री हार्ट ब्लॉक. एज दिस इन दिस पिक वी कैन से नॉर्मली पी आर इंटरवल इट्स मोर देन जीरो नॉर्मली इट इज 0 to 2 seconds बट इट्स मोर देन इफ इट्स कवर मोर देन 1 large square then it will be come under the terminology of the first degree heart block. Preferably that we have to see the L2. In the second degree heart block, in this artery are contracting at a rapid speed. Regularly only few beats are transmitted downwards into the ventricle. It may be possible after 4 beats one ventricle QRS. In second degree heart block, ratio 4:1 in arterial flutter is always second degree heart block. The QRS will be formed after formation of 4 P wave. In third heart block, it is incomplete heart block. There is no correlation between artery and ventricle. It will be conducted at its own irregularly. Now chamber hypertrophy. It's very important in right arterial hypertrophy. We have to see the lead to the height of P wave becomes more than 2.5 mm known as the P pulmonale. Left ventricle hypertrophy. In right RTM hypertrophy, we have to see the height of P wave. In left RTM hypertrophy, we have to see the width of P wave. In left arterial hypertrophy, when the width become more than 3 mm, it is known as the P mitral. And right में it will be when there is a height of P wave become more than 2.5 mm height 2.5 mm then it is the right arterial hypertrophy. Left arterial hypertrophy then the width will be more than 3 mm known as the P mitral. If it's occur then there is something in the And causes of right atrium hypertrophy are tricuspid stenosis, right ventricle failure, pulmonary stenosis, pulmonary hypertension, left atrial hypertrophy, mitral stenosis, left ventricle failure, aortic stenosis, systemic arterial hypertension. And this is very important, left ventricle hypertrophy, main cause for it the persistent hypertension, continuous hypertension. And there are two criteria. On the basis of that, we can calculate the left ventricle hypertrophy. That is the first, the major criteria and the minor criteria. Major criteria. First, we have to calculate the R wave of the V6 lead and S wave of V1 lead. So this is the V6. An S wave of the QR S wave V6. This is the V6. V6 wave. This is the 1 large square. 1 large square. It will be counted as the 5. This is second will be 10. So, if the R wave of V6 and S wave of V1 is more than 35, in this case it is the 5, 5, 10, and S wave it will be more than. It in the lower side. So in this figure it's not indicating, but if R wave or V6 plus S wave of V1 is more than 35, if we calculate like 5, 5, 10 at like 35, it will be known as the left ventricle hypertrophy. If R wave of AVL in this strip AVS is not visible, but we can count the R wave of more than 11, it will be known as the left ventricle hypertrophy. And third point, third major criteria, if R wave of V5 plus V6 more than 27 mm, known as the left ventricle hypertrophy. This is the V5 is covering the वन लार्ज स्क्वायर, सेकंड लार्ज स्क्वायर एंड थर्ड, एंड दी दिस इज दी थर्ड इन दी V5, वन और टू इन दी V6, तो थ्री लार्ज स्क्वायर मल्टीप्लाई 5 15 एंड 2 बाई 5 10 25. So if it's more than 27, then it will be known as the left ventricle hypertrophy. Minor criteria: if the axis is left axis deviation, position is the horizontal, anticlockwise, and the strain pattern ST depression and T wave inversion lead V5, 6, and L1 and AVL. In the right ventricle hypertrophy, major criteria 1 in V1, R wave more than S wave. In V1, in this, if the R wave is more than S wave, if it's 1.5 and it's downward, in the negative deflection is the half, so it will be plus 5. And the minor criteria, right axis deviation, position vertical, clockwise, and ST depression, T wave inversion in the L2, L3, and AVF. Causes of left ventricle: aortic stenosis, systemic arterial hypertension, right ventricle cause. In the pulmonary stenosis, pulmonary hypertension, tricuspid regurgitation. And now the bundle branch block. Right bundle branch block, there are also the major criteria, minus criteria. In the major criteria, we have to see the V1. If V1, there is the formation of RSR-. Means R S R dash, two R wave is formed plus QRS widened. If these two criteria fulfill, then it's known as the right bundle branch. In the V1, R S R dash with QR more than 3, like this. In this way, we can say, in this wave, this is the QR S R dash. Same QR S R dash. The criteria is fulfilling. Plus QRS is more than 3, it's more than 1, is known as the major criteria for the right bundle branch. A minor criteria: ST elevation, inversion in the L2, L3, AVF, axis will be right axis, position will be vertical, and the rotation will be clockwise. And the left axis deviation, we have to see the M pattern. In V6, there will be the QRS will be formed in form MN pattern of QRS. In V1, W pattern, axis is the left axis, horizontal, rotation will be clockwise, anticlockwise. Angina pectoris, partial blockage, as we all know, coronary artery, that causes the more demand for the oxygen, that due to the partial obstruction, more blood needed, but less blood will be entering into the myocardium, that causes the relative ischemia, pain in myocardium, or rest pain will disappears. ST segment depression, T wave inversion on exertion, MI, there will be complete blockage of coronary artery, no blood supply to myocardium, necrosis due to ischemia is known as the infarction, ST elevation, Q wave prominent. After few days, ST segment isolated, Q wave persists, T wave inverted. After next few days, Q wave persists, T wave. Thank you, everyone.